Vedanta, etc., etc., whichever name you know of, and you know somebody there who's senior enough, and ask them how much of, you know, when people pay bills, how much is settled by insurance, how much is settled by government, how much do people pay out of pocket? Usually you get an answer about 3/4 is paid out of pocket. And just imagine those people who are paying that out of pocket, lots of, you know, lakhs and lakhs of rupees every time one visits these hospitals. There's one more stat. 2/3 of personal borrowing in this country is for health reasons, which basically implies all your personal loans, etc., is being driven a lot by health insurance. Now, why wasn't, you would ask me, why wasn't there a lot of insurance coverage provided? And some of you might be connected to policymakers, so I'll make a few points here. See, motor insurance was compulsory, the customer had to buy, so the agent or the seller was a commission taker, he would get his 10-15% commission and life was pretty straightforward. Most of these products, health insurance or life insurance, are costing about between 5,000 to 10,000 rupees. And the remuneration on them was never significant for somebody to go knocking about doors and convincing people that they should buy these particular products. What was on the other hand quite remunerative was these investment products, where you would have somebody come to your house and say, and you know, many of you would have seen this happen either to yourself or to your parents, you know, invest 1 lakh rupees in this, you will get a guaranteed 10% return, 8% is better than FD, it's better than the market. In those products, there were high remuneration plus high ticket size. So it made sense for an agent to come to your house, knock on your doors and sell that particular product. And a lot of the conviction was done on false basis, because most of the products do not actually give you the returns that you would expect. 70-80% of the people would cancel the products. But so there were a lot of issues there, but there was very little in terms of being able to fix the actual health insurance and life insurance issue from whether it was from a government perspective or even today, the life insurance component of insurance is taxed at a higher rate than the savings component. So you would agree, right, that something that should be incentivized actually is disincentivized. I can kind of just keep going over this, you know, there is just so much data available on the various stats that you would see. But one of the interesting pieces again is if you look at again the developed world, developing world, wherever, India has the lowest amount. Okay, so I'll give you some more stats. The total life cover in this country, only 8% of people's income is protected as of today. So if somebody was to, you know, not be there tomorrow, only 8% of their income is protected for their family. 92% is what we call the insurance gap. And the insurance gap, this insurance gap is the highest in the world right now. Out of any country with more than 50 million people, whether it's Indonesia or a China or a US, India has the highest protection gap. And this is obviously been caused because we never really sold term insurance. So there you've got it. Versus the various countries, you've got India having the highest protection gap. I think basically there's a lot of benefits of insurance. I don't want to get over the whole thing. Now, why has, there's one additional piece I wanted to tell you, and this is relevant for IMAI and for this audience. The amount of life cover that is bought in this country, about 30% is bought through the digital channel, which is extremely high, you would agree. So why is it that suddenly insurance is selling through digital? About 15% of health insurance and 30% of the life cover is through the digital channel, not 5% or 10% like other industries. It is because digital suddenly has found a way by which people can come and purchase these products, whether it's a health insurance or a life insurance. It is because people somewhere become aware that they need it. They come and you know, look for their various options and they end up purchasing as well. But with that, the entire delivery mechanism of providing a better experience from a claims perspective and from a servicing perspective is starting to emerge. And you will see a lot more of that happening over the next 3 to 5 years. You know, somebody has to be incentivized to do it. In India, fortunately, we are incentivized to do it. The reason we are incentivized is Because if this happens in large numbers, we still make enough money that we can do it. Something of this sort does not really exist anywhere else in the world. So the PolicyBazaar kind of life insurance, health insurance sales platform does not exist. It is quite unique to India. It's happened here, it's not happened anywhere else. We alone account for 16% of life cover in the country, right? And still we are the lowest in the world. So without this platform, it's much harder to build life cover. And mostly people will take about 10-15% cover, not more than that. So that is the situation, it's a global situation, it has to be solved. There are no easy solutions, because still the commission payable is much higher on the investment products, which are not very useful to the consumer. And as I say, it's a global phenomenon, not just an India phenomenon.
With the PolicyBazaar, are you able to impact the lower, how lower you are able to impact?
Sir, abhi to high rahi nahi khareeda. Log to jab jayenge, jab matlab at least, so I don't want to give a facetious answer to that. See, my view is, as you look at India midterm also, anybody earning less than a certain amount, somewhere the government will provide coverage. And it is somewhere starts becoming the government's job, and the government does do it. As is happening with Ayushman Bharat and various other things. Now, nobody sitting in this room is going to get the Ayushman Bharat coverage, right? We have to arrange our own. And I think in a developed country like the UK or France, even our coverage would have been arranged by the government.